Hi everyone, Amber here, owner and head trainer at Summit Dog Training. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to create group class appointment types in Acuity. There are some really great ways that you can customize the group class settings that Acuity offers and make it work for exactly what you need for your pet business. Don't forget to click subscribe below so that you can catch our new videos on Acuity and other dog topics every week. I've been using Acuity for my dog training business for almost 5 years now, and I love how it has helped us build efficiency and allow us to expand and grow as our business has developed. When I first started using Acuity, I had just a few appointment types, and now, as you can see, things are a little more complicated. But anyways, don't let that overwhelm you. You can start small with a few essentials and build up from there. Today, I'm going to show you how to set up a group service in Acuity that can be used for classes, seminars, and services like daycare or day school, depending on what you offer for your pet business. All right, so let's get started. Under Appointment Types on the left-hand side of your Acuity dashboard, click on New Type of Group Class. From here, you'll be able to edit several settings to customize your group service for what you need. You can add a description of the class that will show up on your client scheduling page. This is really great for putting like what the class is about, any pre-class info that your client might need, like a prerequisite requirement or the name of the instructor that's teaching it, those type of things. Additionally, the title for the class can also be used to convey information to your clients. We use that for explaining what date the class starts on. This is really helpful if you run several classes of the same type, but starting on different dates and running, you know, like puppy basics on Mondays at 6 p.m. or Tuesdays at 9 a.m. You want to be able to quickly differentiate those things. The best way that I've found to do that is by putting that time and date, Tuesday, December 1st at 9 a.m. in the title so that it's one of the very first things that the client can see. Next, you can add a confirmation message. This is something that the client will see after they schedule with you. At Summit, we use this to give clients details about what their class, about what their class entails or what they need to bring or where exactly it's at, that they don't necessarily need before scheduling, but they do need pretty promptly after scheduling. So that's what we use the confirmation message for. You can set the duration of your class in number of minutes. There's also a feature to block off time on your calendar before and after this particular type of group class. This feature isn't as important for pre-scheduled services like classes where you pick the time that the class is offered, but it will be very important when we get to private services or individual services that we schedule for, you know, one client at a time, and we may give the client more leeway when scheduling or more open parameters on our calendar. And so having these buffers built in before and after the appointment can make sure that we have enough time to be efficient there. But you can certainly set that up for the group class system as well. It's just not as important when considering a group class because you're going to pick the time here in a minute, pick the time that that service is offered. So I want to know, what type of group classes and services do you offer your clients? Comment below. Let me know what your top services that might bring people together in a group so we can have a little bit of dialogue about what is the norm and what's most common for our pet businesses. All right, back to working on our group service. I'm going to come back to pricing in a moment because what you set as your price here depends on some of the other settings further down on the page. So we're going to come back to that in a minute. So next, we're going to pick what category you want this service to show up in on your client scheduling page. For example, we have our classes organized by skill level. So clients could see all the level one classes together, all the level two classes, and so on. So you could do something like that if that helps you organize your scheduling page. For location information, this setting is one that you have to request the Acuity team support desk to enable for you. I have found it to be very helpful for many of our group classes that always occur at the same location. But if you don't see it on your screen yet, that's why. Send an email to Acuity if it's a service that or a feature that you'd like, and they can enable it for you on their end. Next, you can choose whether to make your service public or private. If you make it private, it won't show up on your scheduling page that might be linked on your website or your Facebook page or wherever you connect your scheduling page, but students can still sign up if you send them the direct link. So we use the private feature for giving classes or giving students who are on waiting lists for classes first chance to sign up for new classes when we add them to the schedule. So we'll leave it as private, send the waiting list students a direct link that says, hey, you have 48 hours to sign up if you want this spot before it goes public on our website. So snag it, they can use it and use that link to enroll, but it doesn't appear publicly yet. And then after a few days, after that window has passed, we can make it public and open it up for other people to sign up. So that's just one way that we use that feature of toggling back and forth between private and public. The last few settings on this page are really important for configuring your group class exactly the way you want it. Make sure that the class or group event box is checked if you indeed want this to be a group class. If it's not checked, it will not be a group class. It will just be something for one person to sign up for. Then you can choose the number of people you want to be able to enroll for this class. You can set the number to 1 if you want to. I do this when I offer something like Canon Good Citizen Tests, where I want to schedule it at a predetermined time slot, but I only want one person signing up for each time slot. So I will set up a group class, set it at 1, and then one client can sign up for each class. But if you have a regular group class where you do want, 6 or 8 or 10 people to sign up, you need to make sure that you have that number as the capacity for your group. The last setting on this page impacts whether clients will need to sign up for all of the times that you list or whether it's something they can choose to come to one date at a time instead. If you check this box saying clients must come to all the times offered, it will sell the clients a series of classes. For example, a 6-week puppy class that has a start date and an end date and 6 dates of class in between, or 4 dates of class in between. If this box is not checked, then clients can pick one of the dates that you have listed, just one of the dates you have listed, to enroll and enroll just on that one date. Both of these can be very useful depending on the type of service you're trying to offer, whether you're trying to offer a drop-in class or a series of classes. It's important to know that they do impact your pricing setting, which is why I left that blank, and we're going to come back and talk about that now. If you list the price as the cost of a complete 6-week group class, but then you don't have this box checked, then your clients will be charged that price for each week that they sign up for. For example, let's just say you charge a 6-week class is $200, and you have that as the price, but that box is not checked. And so your client goes to enroll and they somehow manage to select 6 dates in a row because they're like, it's supposed to be a 6-week class, right? They sign up for 6 dates and then they're going to come and go to the checkout page. The price that they will see will be 6 times 200. So $1,200 would be the price at their checkout point that they would be being asked to pay, which if you've marketed a class for $200 for a 6-week class is going to be very confusing for the client and you're going to get some phone calls. So you want to make sure that those settings match up consistently, whether they're supposed to sign up for 1 week or multiple. Okay, next step is to choose which intake forms to assign with which with this service that you're creating. I cover intake forms in another video, so we'll just pick a few to go with this service as an example. These are the forms your client will see when they go submit an enrollment for this service. Now, we're all set and ready to save the service. We still have one last step to complete in order to make this group class schedulable for our clients. And that's picking the dates and times that it will be offered. To do that, you're going to click on this plus offer button and pick the date and time of the first class. You can choose to offer it recurring on the same day of the week multiple times, or recurring on a different day of the week. To do same day of the week, you'd click recurring and select the number of weeks you want it to populate. Keep in mind that if you put 20 dates on here and then have that box that said client must sign up for all times that are offered, if you have that box checked, it will automatically enroll the client in all 20 dates. And that's all set up, looking good and ready to get your clients scheduled. To learn more about Acuity for your pet business, you can grab my free 10-part checklist specifically for pet pros. I go through the top 10 steps to get Acuity scheduling set up for your business to build efficiency, effectiveness, and save you time and ultimately money with your Acuity scheduling software. Click the link below in the description to get your guide. It's free, and I hope it is helpful in launching you in Acuity. I know I have loved this software, and I'm just excited to share it with other people. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, and check out some of the other videos on our channel. Have a great day and see you next time.